Baseball from the Lone Star State. Game one of the American League Division Series. It's the Seattle Mariners taking on the Houston Astros. First pitch coming your way next.
And now, your 2022 Houston Astros.
All right, ready to get underway. Here's the veteran second baseman, Adam Frazier. The 1-1. On the ground to the left. In time to Gurriel. And a quick out number one. Ty France up next for the Mariners. Packed house here at Minute Maid. The next offering misses. Now two balls and a strike. One down, base is empty. And a good eye there.
The count was 3-1.
The wind of the pitch. There's a strike. No score, just getting started, top of the first. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Well, he got challenged with a good fastball right there. Just couldn't catch up.
And that one is lifted in the air. McCormick drifts towards it. Hauls it in for the out. Two outs, base is empty. And now the DH, Jesse Winker. The wind of the pitch. That's a strike. It's a ball and two strikes.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch and not sure exactly what type.
He locked him up, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Back here in Houston and stepping in for the Astros, Jose Altuve. Next pitch is in the dirt. 2-1. Just missed. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
And now a full count. Righty to the plate. Line drive to short and caught. Now Michael Brantley steps in.
The left fielder, Michael Brantley.
2-1 now. That one is absolutely belted. That's back. Hauls it in on the warning track.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it. Here's Alex Bregman.
Third baseman, Alex. Bregman.
1-2 now. And that's outside.
The guy at the plate could recognize slider out of the hand. Didn't stay in the tunnel very long in terms of depth and perception. He knew right away it was an off-speed pitch.
And here it comes. And down on strikes he goes, and that'll do it. Back here at Minute Maid Park, new inning getting started. Now batting Mitch Haniger. Broken bat, roller to first. A flip to the pitcher covering, and they take care of Haniger for the out.
Good fastball in on the hands. Makes the swing a little defensive. Jammed him up right there.
Second inning here. No score. Next pitch misses. 2-1. Kicks and fires. On the corner for a strike.
Looks like a really good fastball today. You can hear that catcher's mitt popping. Looking forward to hearing a lot of that one in this one.
Next offering misses, and the count is filled up. Out to center. And makes the grab. Two down. J.P. Crawford now at the plate. J.P. Crawford. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Third out. Back here in Houston. Bottom of the second. Now it's Yordan Alvarez. On the ground right side. Frazier on the first in time. Yeah, they get the out on Alvarez. Yuli Gurriel comes up to hit. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. Swing and a hard hit liner up the middle and a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Here's Kyle Tucker. And the next pitch is way outside.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Gurriel over at first with one away. Grounder might be two to Crawford for one. Back to first for two, and that'll do it. And welcome back. Well, here we go. Top of the third, scoreless game. This is Kyle Lewis. The pitch. Singy, one of the things that's interesting is that guys really don't worry about swing and miss from an offensive standpoint anymore. So when you see somebody who contacts the ball like this, do you think of that as plus value?
Absolutely. If he's doing damage now, if he's rolling over and grounding out, then it's a different story. But yeah, if he can put the ball in the gaps or over the fence, 100%.
Ground ball up the middle, and it gets by him. Here's Jared Kelnick. And the pitch. Now a fly ball to right center. Tucker on the move as he glides back. And it's caught. And there's one down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
The pitch. Swings here and blasts one left field. Pulls it in on the warning track. Here's Adam Frazier. Grounded out to short in his first trip. Verlander moved to first. Lewis back in standing. Left-hand hitter waits. Out to short. Pena collects. Whips it to first. That's out number three. Welcome back as we go to the last of the third. And stepping in for the Astros, Chaz McCormick. Next offering is in for a strike. The wind and the pitch. And a foul ball. Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. Chaz McCormick muscles one out. And they grab the lead. It's 1-0. Next up, it's the first-year shortstop, Jeremy Pena. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Cut on and miss, struck him out. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer. Martin Maldonado up to hit. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. The punch out there, and there are two outs. Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. Two outs. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One and two now. Altuve waits. Swing and a ball popped up. And a base hit right there. And Michael Brantley with a chance to make an impact with two away.
Hooked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely. And that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off.
Gilby over to first. Altuve back safely. Michael Brantley stands in. Out towards left center. And that'll get down for a hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Back-to-back singles. Kind of a risky pitch coming inside with the breaking ball like that. You have to bury it. Otherwise, it's not too difficult to get the bat to it like he did that time.
Next offering is down low. And a count 2-1. Here comes a pitch. Lined into right, and that's a base hit. Right past his coach, headed for the plate. The throw is offline, and he's in to score. And they lead by two.
Stringing them together, that's three hits in a row. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted in first base with a quick free pass.
And a pitch. Missing inside. Three balls and a strike. The pitch. 3-2 now.
Can't get too big here, Boog, with the bases loaded.
The pitch. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Lewis should have this one. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Back here at the ballpark, and now the first baseman, Ty France. And the pitch. That smash towards center. McCormick racing over to make the catch.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it, but in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Up the middle, dives, and he can't hang on. And he beats it. That's a hit. Great try there. One gone, runner at first. And now the right fielder, Mitch Haniger. And a pitch. And it's even up.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Two and two. And a foul ball. He stays alive. At the belt and fires. Off the outside edge with that one. And now it's filled up. Back to work. 3-2 now. stays alive. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And ball four to aboard.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound, but you know his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this, but he's gonna have to buckle down right here.
Two on, one out. And now one and two. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Now two away. J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit. J.P. Crawford. 2-2 now. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Pulls it in on the run. And that will end the inning. Of the fourth. Now it's the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. Righty delivers. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit by pitch to lead off the inning.
Well, looks like he wanted that slider to finish on the inside part of the plate, not start on the inside and end up hitting the batter. It looked to me like he just tried to do a little too much with that one.
Lifted in the air, right center field. Lewis gliding to his left. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Next offering is in for a strike. Just off the inside edge.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Checks over to first, back safely. In the air, right field, Haniger under it. Puts the squeeze on that one, and there's two down. And here's the catcher, Martin Maldonado. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. In there. And so now one and two.
You come into the game knowing that unless the ball's in the dirt or gets by him, we're probably not going to steal anything today. So that's where you want to get a little more.
He swings and drives one out to deep left field. And that ball is gone. So he just clears the wall, and they tack on to their lead. It's 4-0. So the batting order turns over. Jose Altuve up to hit here. That hits the dirt, and it's 2-1.
Well, I'll say this as a former position player and base stealer. When you come into a game and you've got a guy like this behind the dish with a big arm, you really have to change your approach. Can't try to steal because you'll get thrown out. Maybe get a little bigger lead, be aggressive on the secondary, but this type of guy shuts the running game down.
Out there to center, Lewis has this one sized up, pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And that ends the inning. Back here in Houston, ready now for the fifth inning. And now for Seattle, Kyle Lewis. And the righty deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. 2-2 now. On the ground at first. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. One away here in the fifth. And up next for Seattle, Jarred Kelnick. Here's a 1-1. There's the strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. That's out number two. Now it's Tom Murphy. Fly to left his first time up. The wide to kick the pitch. Got a curve, drops in for a strike.
Looking sharp, just a strike away from five shutout innings.
In the air, right field. Could be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. Oh, the throw is wild.
He's safe.
Adam Frazier up next for the Mariners. The 2-1. That's through there for a strike.
I got to count two and two.
Man, it's second. That one just misses. Murphy stands at second with two gone. And down on strikes. Third out, and that ends the frame. Back here at Minute Maid Park, bottom of the inning. Here's Michael Brantley. And he walked him.
Boom, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. So out of the bullpen for the Mariners, Justice Sheffield.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Alex Bregman, the next to hit, one for two. The pitch. Smoked on the ground a second, and it finds its way through for a hit. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out.
I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Here's Jordan Alvarez. That's a laser base hit. Brantley on his way to the plate. He'll score, and the lead is up to five.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Here's Gurriel. Fly ball to right. One down. So digging in, Kyle Tucker.
The right fielder, number 30, Kyle Tucker.
And here it comes. Ground ball left side, could be two. Over to Frazier. Throw, and it gets away. To the right side. Frazier picks it up. Now the throw to first on the run. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. Here in Houston, now the number two hitter, Ty France.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some guys. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
The wind of the pitch. And a swing and a miss. So he's gotten deep into this game. And at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. Here's Jesse Winker. 2-2. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And stepping in for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger. A on the ground to first. Takes it himself, and the Mariners set down 1-2-3. Welcome back. Now it's going to be Jeremy Peña. And he deals. Ripped on a line. Lewis puts it away. One up, one down. Martin Maldonado digs in now.
Martin Maldonado.
The next offering misses. 2-1.
Two on the count.
And now the lefty. In the air to left center. Lewis ranging to his right. Drops into the glove. And there's two away. So the Houston lineup turns over. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. 1-3. Next offering in the dirt. And that's ball two. The wind of the pitch. That misses. Ball three. Lifted in the air out to left. Crawford on the move. Makes the grab. That is the inning. Back here at the ballpark, here's a big power threat. Eugenio Suarez. The 1-2. And now it's filled up. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Kicks and deals. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
Ground ball to the right side, and that's a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it. Right on time, good balanced approach, and just blasted it through the infield.
Next pitch is inside, and that's ball two. Line drive, base hit down the line. And that's going to kick into the corner. Throw into third. And he's in there. A run comes in on the play.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask.
Swings and misses. And that is strike two. And the right-hander deals. Stays alive. Base runners at second and third here. No outs. And he grounds one to the right side. And foul ball. Base hit. One run is in. In there safely.
Picks himself up in RBI. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and ripped it into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
They hand the ball over to a new arm, Phil Maton, trying to protect this lead. Tom Murphy up next for the Mariners.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
And the pitch. And he pumps it a strike. One and two here. And a ball evens the count. The 2-2. That to right. And it's just foul. That's out to center field. A little bloop single. In comes the run from third to trim the lead. It's 6-3.
Well done. Narrows the deficit with the RBI there. You'll take those bloop hits off the end of the bat all day long. It doesn't mean you put a great swing on it, but hitters deserve to get a lucky hit every now and then.
And now here is Adam Frazier. Altuve handles it, drops it, but they're saying it was on the transfer.
The first baseman, number 23, Ty Frank.
Swing and a miss. That is strike two.
Well, now that this is a bullpen game, it's clear that whichever bullpen steps up the most is likely going to come away with the W.
Still only one out here in the inning. Next pitch misses way outside.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
The Astros turn to a new arm on the mound, Blake Taylor. And he'll work on holding this lead.
Now pitching for the Astros, number 62, Blake Taylor.
Now, Jesse Winker. Frazier off of first with two away. And that one fouled off. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. And welcome back. Bottom of the seventh. And stepping in for the Astros, Michael Brantley. Kicks and fires. Good eye right there. Left-hand hitter waits. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Hauls it in, and there's one away. And now it's Alex Bregman for the fourth time tonight.
Bregman.
The pitch. And a count 1-2.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down.
That one ripped right center field. Leaping try, but it's off his glove. It's a double, third hit of the night for him. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Yordan Alvarez. The pitch.
Ball, that's out.
Runner at second here, one gone. Swings and misses, and we're filled up.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Fouled off left side.
Hanging in there pretty good against the lefty.
The pitch. Up the middle. In plenty of time to first. And they get the out on Alvarez.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front, rolled over on it. Exactly what it was supposed to do.
Runner at third, two away. Swing at a ball lifted to center field. Lewis settles under this one. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. So a new pitcher out of the bullpen for the Astros, Hector Neris.
Number 50, Hector Neris.
We go to the eighth, and now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. And down on strikes he goes. First out in the top of the eighth. And Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. One one now. And there's a foul ball. Right-handed reliever on the ground to third, and he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket. The 1-2. There's the splitter in the dirt, swing and a miss. Gets the out, two down after the strikeout. J.P. Crawford getting ready to hit. Right-hander kicks, deals. And that one in the air center field. McCormick glides back, makes the grab, and that's the inning. Back here in Houston, bottom of the eighth. And now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. Here's a 1-1. They say it went.
One ball, two strikes, yeah.
A wind and a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Next pitch misses. And the count is 2-2. Left-hand batter waits. Stays alive. And a pitch. And he grounds one back up the middle. Fires over to first. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. And now the center fielder, Chaz McCormick. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond. And this guy is at the top of the list. That one fouled off. The pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Swing and a slow roller. Tosses to first. Two up, two down. Two outs, base is empty. Now at the plate, Jeremy Pena.
Been a solid inning so far in relief. Getting them through this inning only down two could give their lineup a real opportunity to just grind their way back into this game with the few outs that they have left.
And it's through for a hit. And that extends the inning.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes.
Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
And here is Martin Maldonado. Sheffield to first. And he dives back in safely. Out towards right center field. Haniger makes the catch, and that'll do it. So here comes Ryan Pressly to the mound, and he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball. Here in Houston, and now Kyle Lewis. In the air out towards right center. McCormick under it. Brings it in. One away. So up next, Jared Kelnick. 1-2. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Two gone. Two outs. Base is empty. So here's Murphy now. And that one is lifted in the air. He pulls it down. Ball game. And the Astros claim game one here at home.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
Here's one final look at the line score from this one, Chris.
It was a close two-run game, and a couple of key moments just really made the difference. Not much separates these two teams.
And this one ends with a final score of 6-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.